Hello, people of God. So today is actually the 29th of August, 2020. What an awesome God that we serve. Hallelujah. What an awesome God we serve. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for that 24-hour miracle yesterday, Lord. Thank you for that 24-hour miracle yesterday. Only you can do what you have done, oh Lord. You are God all by yourself. Thank you, Jesus. We praise you. We honor you. We give you all the glory for your great grace and your mighty hands surpass all human understanding. We bless your holy name. We exalt you, oh God. You alone deserve all the glory. You alone deserve all the praise. 1 John 2:15 says, "Do not love the world or anything that is in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love for the Father is not in them." And one man of God was describing, you know, that contrast in a way where the Bible is saying that we should not love the world, nor the things that is in the world. Because if we do, the love of the Father is not in us. Yet, the Bible says, for God so loved the world. So there's a difference between love and love. And because most of the time, what men describe as love is not really love. You know, so we can't love the world, you know, when we are supposed to be giving Jesus to them. Because remember, he says, if you love anything that is in the world, the love of the Father is not in us. So in other words, if only we are giving the world the love of the Father or giving Jesus to the world, then we are permitted to love the world because Jesus himself loved the world. And he gave himself up so that the world can be reconciled back to him and that we can love him just as he intended for us to love him. And 2 Peter 1:20 says, "Above all, you must understand that no prophecy of Scripture came about by the prophet's own interpretation of things." We know that prophecy is the word from God, but many a times, even in our generation, many people have interpreted, you know, prophecy by their own understanding and interpretation. It was never like that. It was God's word to mankind that he uses men as instrument to speak to them. Very often, you know, God spoke to different men at different times to fulfill what he wanted to fulfill. But like we said, now we are in the New Testament, a dispensation of the, even though God can still use other men, he also has come to indwell in us in the form of the Holy Spirit. So even if he tried to use another man, it is always important that he also will speak to our heart. Because he said there is a spirit that is within us, that Christ, our Abba Father. So if God is speaking through another person to us, we also will have some sort of conviction, confirmation from the Holy Spirit, because we do have access to the same God that they are talking about, that they are bringing, you know, the message that they are bringing from God to us. Is above all, we must understand. Yes. Colossians 3 verse 12 says, "Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and peace." We pray that as people of God, as children of God in the Universal Church, this will mark us as children of God, the fruit of the Spirit. Remember, Jesus has come to dwell in us in the form of the Holy Spirit. And when someone dwells in you, or the Holy Spirit dwells in you, there's evidence of it, which is the outward working of compassion and kindness and humility and gentleness and patience. We pray these will mark us as children and as people of God in this generation, in Jesus' name. And then he goes on to say in John chapter 15, verse 26, "When the advocate comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who goes out from the Father, he will testify about me. The Holy Spirit is described as the Spirit of truth. Remember, it's not anything new, because anything that is not of truth is not of God. Jesus came and he proclaimed the same thing. He said, I'm the way, I'm the truth, and I'm the life. So, and he said, but I'm going, and I'm going to replace me physically, being physical on the earth, with the promised Holy Spirit. And that's exactly what he did, you know. So we thank God for, you know, all the great and wonderful, marvelous things that he continues to do in our lives. We say, take glory, Father, take glory, Son, and take glory, Holy Spirit. We are worthy.